Once upon a time, when Patan was the capital of state of Gujarat, Rani Udayamati built the step well in remembrance of her king. One would question what was the vision of the queen while building this well. Number one, in the olden days, women used to commit sati, jumping into the fire after the death of their husband. She wanted to end this practice and hence well and water. Second was to create job employment. Third, women had to go through a lot of ordeal collecting water, and this well reduced their physical efforts. The steps too created are designed in such a way that helps reduce physical exertion. It also acted as a night halt for travelers, and due to the hot and dry climate, this well brought about coolness in the environment. What was the reason behind such beautiful carvings and what's depicted in it? Number one, she thought if we have beautiful carvings, the people will not contaminate the water. Second, the king and the queen will be remembered for a long time. The carvings belong to Dashavatar, which is the 10th avatar of Vishnu, goddess Durga, Shiv, and patola design, which is used exclusively in Patan patola sarees. Some interesting trivias. It's been built in the 11th century. It disappeared and submerged due to the floods in river Saraswati. Government of India came to know of its existence in 1958 and the excavation started in 1963. And the work got over in 1993. In the year 2014, it was declared as UNESCO World Heritage Site, and in 2018, its image appeared on the 100 rupee currency note. The finest and one of the largest example of its kind and designed as an inverted temple, highlighting the sanctity of water, the stepwell is divided into 7 layers of stairs with sculptural panels. More than 500 principal sculptures and over 1,000 minor ones combined religious, mythological and secular imagery. It was built in the memory of King Bhima I by Queen Udayamati. It was also named as India's cleanest iconic place in 2016. That's Rani Ki Vav, one of the very few monuments in the world constructed in remembrance of the king by a queen, and that too constructed with a vision and foresight.